Hello, everyone. My name is Adrian Fernandez, and welcome to another episode of Connect. Today, we have Andres Blanco here from our 802.15.4 software applications team. So thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, so we've had a few other guests here introducing this brand new kit, the LaunchPad SensorTag kit, or LPSTK. And we wanted to walk through a little bit of the sub-1 gigahertz capability that this device has. So coming from our 802.15.4 team, can you talk a little bit about the TI-15.4 stack?
Yeah, sure. Our 802.15.4 stack is our proprietary 802.15.4 protocol stack that we develop in-house. It has a lot of features, such as, first of all, it's low power, very important. Yep. You can get sub-microamp average power consumption. Not only that, but it also provides you with over 2 miles of range. When using this sub-1 gigahertz physical layer at 50 kbps or at 5 kbps. We also offer you, like I just mentioned, multiple PHYs. So you can use it in China. You could use it here in the US with the FCC. You can also use it in Europe with the ETSI band. And you have also three different data rates that you can use, which are 5 kilobits per second, 50 kilobits per second, and 200 kilobits per second.
Wow. Yep. So super flexible.
Yeah, very flexible.
Okay, and I know we just released this new sysconfig tool, and I think that should probably help with some of the configuration options.
It's a lot better. Now with sysconfig, you'll be able to configure the whole network using a brand new GUI. It's going to be very easy to set up a network in less than a minute or two.
That's incredible. Yep. And I guess one of the other aspects of the 15.4 stack is the number of nodes that we support. So not only is it really long range, but could you quantify how many nodes you might be able to connect to
a
network?
If you're in a typical network of sub-1 gigahertz here in the US, you can actually have around 200 plus nodes connected to a single collector.
Incredible. So we won't have 200 here today. Looks like we've got about 3 or 4.
Yeah.
What we wanted to walk through here is, I guess, the 15.4 use case that's preloaded into the mobile app, the app for the LaunchPad SensorTag kit. Yep. Yeah, do you mind walking through what that use case looks like?
Yeah, definitely. So over here, we have our LPSTK board out of the box with the BLE image that comes with it.
Okay.
And using the BLE starter app, let's go and search for the device. It's already here for us.
Okay.
Let's touch and go into sensor view. Here in the sensor view, as you can see, you get all the sensor values at the moment, but we're going to go straight into our firmware download option.
Okay, and this will allow us to over-the-air download a new image to the LPSTK.
Yeah. What we're trying here to do is connect with the app through BLE connection and download an image that will allow you to also communicate through sub-1 gigahertz.
Okay, very good.
Yeah. So we will go into the firmware file, and we're going to select our 15.4 sensor image.
Okay.
At this point, you're ready to program it. Just press the button program.
Oh, let me do that? All right, yeah, let's do it. Awesome. Cool. So I guess while this is over the air downloading this new image, do you want to maybe like walk through the different hardware boards here and kind of where they fit in the overall topology?
Yeah, definitely. So over here we have basically these are the same LPSTK boards without their casing.
Okay.
And these are already pre-programmed with the same image I'm downloading here at the moment.
Gotcha.
So let's just call this one sensor 1, sensor 2, sensor 3. And now this one, since it's, we're programming it right now to have the same functionality as this one, sensor 4.
Okay, great.
Yeah, all these sensors are going to be connected to a single collector device. The collector device, like the name suggests, will collect data from all the sensors.
Gotcha.
This is going to be only one. And like I mentioned before, we're only doing 4 here.
Right.
But you can connect around 200 here. So let's just call this one collector.
Okay. And I guess in this case, this is a star topology.
It's a star topology. So you will have them connected like this, and it's bidirectional communication. So like I mentioned, all of them here, bidirectional communication.
Okay.
And we're going to be configuring it as a non-beacon communication. There's 3 different modes to our stack. We have frequency hopping. As the name suggests, the devices are going to be all hopping in different frequencies.
Okay.
This will allow you to have better noise reduction and better communication, more robust. We also have non-beacon mode, which is more of a direct communication kind of sequence, and then beacon mode, which they all sync to a single beacon with the collector.
Awesome. So I guess in addition to obviously having the example in the mobile app to be OAD'd to the LaunchPad here, the LaunchPad sensor tag, are these examples also delivered in the SimpleLink SDK?
Yeah, all of these examples that we're running here, even the one that we're downloading directly into the LPSTK, can be found in our online SDK package.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So customers can use it as a starting point, make modifications to it, so on and so forth.
Yeah.
Okay, very cool. And I guess in this case, obviously, there's some onboard sensors here. So are we actually reading those sensor values, throwing it into some sort of payload, and then sending it to the collector periodically?
Yep. So the way this is going to be working is we're going to boot them up as soon as this one finishes downloading. And we're going to go into our SDK example over here.
Okay.
And I'm going to walk you through how to configure the collector example to be able to receive data from these different sensors.
Okay.
And then from there, you'll be able to see how all of these sensors are going to be starting sending data periodically. Mm-hmm. And you'll be able to see this data over on your screen.
Very cool. So it looks like this guy's programmed. So I guess now the next step, like you said, is to make changes here to the collector.
Yeah, let's go.
Awesome. So for this, we'll be using Code Composer Studio?
Yeah, we'll be using Code Composer Studio with our out-of-the-box SDK. Let's go over to Import CCS Project, press the Browse button, and go straight to where you downloaded and installed your SDK.
Okay.
At this case, you're going to go to Examples, RTOS 1352R1, which is the device that we have on board here. This is our multi-protocol device, which allows you to have 2.4 gigahertz communication and sub-1 gigahertz communication, in this case, Bluetooth, plus our TI-15.4 stack.
Very cool.
In this case, we're going to go to our DMM, which stands for Dynamic Multimode Manager.
Okay. So in that case, multiple stacks in one.
Basically, yeah. You can have two types of different communication schemes in one single example.
Okay.
That's all it means. Import the example.
Okay. Awesome.
Once you import your example, open the example, go straight to the application folder, open the collector folder, go to the csf.c file. This stands for collector specific functions. What we're trying to do here is, by default, the collector basically is going to show you the temperature that the sensor is sending over.
Okay, gotcha.
But we want to take advantage of all the other sensors.
Right.
So let's go ahead and add a single line, or modify the line that's already existing and make it show also the humidity and the RSSI and the XYZ coordinates of the accelerometer.
Okay, cool.
For this, just go to line 829 and add the following.
Okay, very cool. Yeah, and I think we have a sibling academy that even walks through these steps, sort of step by step, right?
Yeah.
So customers can extend our examples to take advantage of these new sensor values.
All of this is documented in our SLAs.
Okay,
Simple Link Academies.
So after all of these modifications, at that point, we can go ahead and program our collector.
We can go ahead and program it. Let's go and do that and see what happens. Now that this is programmed, let's go ahead and plug it in. We can see here that the TI collector has showed up.
And we're just in a terminal here, just interacting over UART.
Yeah, this is just sending information through UART. It's going to give you this cool little menu, which allows you to configure the device, have some actions on the network, such as opening the network, closing the network, or some app-specific functions. And for this particular occasion, we want to go straight into network actions, and we want to form a network. So before we even have devices connect to you, you need to form the network. So you just go in there, press enter. It's going to give you some information on the network, such as the mode that we're in, non-beacon mode, like I mentioned before, our address, our PAN ID, the channel that we're operating on, and if our network is open or not. So at this moment, in order to have our sensors join, we need to open the network. That way,
you formed the network. Now you need to enable it almost, or turn it on.
Yeah. So for that, you just press the right arrow, and you're going to have the open network function.
Okay.
At this point, if you look at the board, our red LED is flashing or toggling, and this basically indicates that you have an open network. At this point, we are ready to turn on our devices.
Okay, cool.
Let's go over here, like switch it on, switch them on one by one, and they should be able to join instantly.
Cool. Awesome. So now we've got basically four nodes operating the same example. So what needs to happen for these nodes to now provision to the network that we've opened on the collector?
Yeah. So after opening the network, go ahead and power on all these devices by switching this switch over here.
Okay.
It's going to give you a quick little blink of the red LED. Mm-hmm. Once it does that, go ahead and press the left button. That will be button one.
Okay. Yep.
That would enable the sensor to start looking for a collector to connect to.
Gotcha.
Once it connects, as you can see, all of these are connected right now, it will light up the red LED and stay on.
Okay, so solid red light means it's found the network, it's connected, and now it's essentially sending sensor data.
It's basically working right now. As you can see over here on the screen, we can see that the number of joint devices is 4.
Very cool, yeah.
And then on top of that, you can see the device status. So every time a new message comes in, you can see, so here, the sensor is going to change, and its temperature, humidity, and RSSI value.
Okay, cool. So we're seeing sensor data as well as the address or the source of where that sensor value came from.
Yep. And as you can see, you know, we've got 1, 2, 3, and 4 in the order in which they connected to the network. The collector gives it a short address.
Okay, very cool. Yep. Andres, this is awesome. So now that we've got our 15.4 network set up, I guess one thing that we've got to remind ourselves is that Bluetooth is still available, right?
Yep.
We're able to use the DMM capability to run not just a 15.4 stack, but Bluetooth connection to a mobile phone as well.
Mm-hmm.
And what's a use case where that might be useful?
So one of the really big ones is what we just did right now. So let's say that you have a new image, and you want to have some type of new functionality. You can download that image into the device using a smartphone or a tablet, like in this case. Another really cool use case would be, in this particular case, is actually broadcasting some of the information from the network. So if you were to look at your iPhone app or Android app, you can actually see the reporting interval and modify it. You can see the PAN ID, the channels, any type of network information you want to access, you'll be able to access it.
Gotcha.
And this is important because let's say that in this case, we have buttons that we can press to provision, but maybe you want something more compact without buttons. So in this case, you would use a phone, and you can tell it, hey, connect to this collector. So that's one of the many use cases.
Very cool. Yeah, that's awesome. And I guess in addition to some of the stack parameters, we could also mirror the same sensor values to the Bluetooth phone as well, in addition to broadcasting over 15.
The same way that our starter app shows you the sensor values, you can do the same thing right now with this demo.
Really cool. Andres, thank you so much for walking through this. This is an excellent example of showing how you can use the long range capabilities of 15.4, but the accessibility of Bluetooth with a mobile phone, all with one chip.
I'm happy to help.
Awesome. Andres, thank you so much for hanging out with us today. And thank you guys for watching. As always, be sure to send us any feedback or ideas on Twitter at Sensor2Cloud. You know, reach out to us. We're really happy to hear from you guys. And be sure to tune in next week, where we'll have another Simplink expert to talk about brand new technology that we're bringing to market. So thank you so much. We'll catch you guys later.